Hi students, as I told you in my first lecture on RTD, okay, so what are the exceptional features of capsule type SPRTs over the stem type SPRT? So the as I told you, the sheath is made of platinum, okay. So in case of stem type SPRT, the sheath was made of other material, okay. But here it is like fused silica and sandblasted glass or alumina. So that are used for stem type. Here directly platinum sheath is used. Okay, and the sheath diameter is about 5 millimeter and overall length is 60 millimeter only. Okay, so for stem type it is the length was 402. The length sheath diameter was 0.7 centimeter. Okay, in case of stem type, the sheath diameter was 0.7 centimeter and length was 400 to 800 millimeter. Compared to this, it is only 60 millimeter. That means it is very small, very very small. And diameter compared to 0.7 centimeter in case of stem type, it is only 5 millimeters, so it's a really very micro size. I mean, that's why the name is capsule type SPRT. Okay, and what are the common features? The common features are the sheath is filled with dry air at a pressure of 30 kilopascal, 1/3 to half atmosphere or 1 atmosphere for low temperature. This filling with dry gas is necessary to avoid insulation leakage through the release of moisture from mica. Okay, so this dry gas filling inside the sheath is very much needed for both type of, it is common for both type, that means capsule type as well as the stem type of SPRTs. Okay, and this dry gas filling is very much necessary to avoid any insulation leakage through the release of moisture from mica. So as mica has been used for insulation, okay, that means the wear is owned, platinum wear is owned on the mica insulation. So due to some reaction, whenever it is heated, some reaction from mica, some moisture can come. That's why dry gas is very much required inside. Okay, then sometimes air is also used to make the atmosphere oxidizing to a certain extent. Okay, platinum does not get oxidized easily even in the presence of oxygen. So platinum is a very good quality material, oxidization is very less, but in reducing the reducting atmosphere silica in the insulation formers is reduced to silicon, which then reacts with the platinum to form an alloy, making it brittle and changing its characteristics. So platinum oxidization, I mean oxidation, chemical reaction with oxygen is very easily, okay, platinum does not get oxygen easily, it is not done, but whenever it is basically heating is going on, okay, so atmosphere silica is there, so due to the presence of silica, I mean what will happen, the platinum will react with the oxygen actually, okay, so it will basically make an alloy, okay, so silicon it will make one alloy, the platinum will make one alloy. Okay, and presence of oxygen basically. So what will happen? There will be one alloy of platinum, silica and oxygen, and that's why it will be brittle. Okay, so that is the problem encountered with platinum. Otherwise it is good, but the presence of silicon, it is changing its chemical characteristics, and that's why, its characteristics is getting changed. Okay. And annealing is very much necessary, so it is a common thing. So whatever I am telling right now, that is a common for stem type and capsule type both. That means dry air, okay, so filling dry air, this is very important. Inside the sheath, it is very, very important. And annealing is also very important. Okay. So, these are the common features of capsule type SPRTs and stem type SPRTs. Okay. After that, after completing the SPRTs, now we will move on the IPRTs, that means industrial platinum resistance thermometer. Okay, so industrial platinum resistance thermometer is used for basically industrial purpose. So what are the, first of all we need to know what are the industrial requirements. Industry basically works at a very high temperature, and that atmosphere is environment or atmosphere is not basically very favorable atmosphere. Okay, so whatever device you are using over there, it must have the capability of withstanding vibrations and shakes, and response means output. Okay, so output from the device should be very faster, otherwise there will be problem in sequencing. That means in a process control industry, there are sequential works. Okay, so if the sequence or synchronization in between the different components is missing, then there will be total collapse of the process control. Okay, to the industrial process, there will be a total collapse. So that's why we need a faster response. Otherwise, the things can get worse. Okay, so this should be the properties of industrial sensors, not only for IPRTs, for industrial purpose. If you use some device, that device should have those features. Okay, so withstanding capacity of vibration and shakes, then faster response, and must be designed both in size and shape. The size and shape should be basically customized, should be customized based on the environment where it is used. Okay, so these three are the very important features required. Okay, and that must be rugged construction. Rugged construction should be there. IPRT can be broadly classified into two categories or classes, class A and class B. And this is the temperature range from 200 degree centigrade to 650 degree centigrade. This is the range of class A, that means temperature range to be measured. Okay, similarly for class B, it is minus 200 degree centigrade to 850 degree centigrade. So this is where basically this classification is based on the temperature range to be measured. Okay, and the standard resistance value of IPRT is 100 ohm at 0 degree centigrade temperature. This is the standard one. There are some manufacturers are there who basically chose some resistance which is different than 100 ohm. Okay, what is the governing equation? This is the governing equation. So here R0, that means initial resistance is 100 degree centigrade. Okay, and alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 values are specified, but time to time it is reviewed. Sometimes it may get changed. That's why for industry application is a very sensitive application. That's why there is a routine checkup of alpha 1, alpha 2 and alpha 3 values with the help of advanced technology instruments. Okay. Another type of classification of IPRT, wear type and thin or thick film type. Wear type construction is there, wear diameter in between 0.001 to 0.005 centimeter in case of wear type IPRT. For thin or thick film type IPRT, films are deposited on ceramic substrates. Okay, so these are the main features, okay, categorical features of IPRT. Now come to wear type IPRT. So these are the few variations of wear type IPRT. Okay, so this variety, sometimes the wear is embedded in aluminium powder. This is the platinum wear. See, this one is the platinum wear, and this is the cage. Okay, so this cage basically is used for the support purpose of the well. Okay, otherwise there will be it will be encountering some problem whenever if it is kept in industrial environment. Okay, so due to temperature rise, there will be obviously there will be resistance change, and there will be some basically stress and strain type of forces, and that's why it needs a support. Okay, so this frame is or cage is used for support, and this is basically guard. This is the guard with ventilation. Okay, so this is one type of basically well type instrument. Okay, second variety of well type C, this is the ceramic rod. Ceramic means, okay, this is insulating material. Ceramic rod is there, and the outside coating is glass, and this is basically the wear. Okay, so this wear, two terminals of the wear. Okay, these are the two terminals of the wear, and basically if it is kept, it will accordingly the resistance of the wear will change according to the temperature. Okay, where it will be kept. Okay, so in this way, by measuring the resistance, I can basically take an indirect reading of the environment temperature. Okay, so this is another type of well type IPRT. The third variation is this one. Okay, so see this one, outside this is glass and platinum wares are there, and this is basically ceramic tube. Okay, so this is the third variety, and these are basically called, see, this is like a pin. Okay, so these two varieties, this one and this one, they can be called the well type IPRTs. Okay, pin type, sorry, where in between wear type, this is basically pin type, behaving like a pin. Okay, so this is, these two variants are called pin type IPRTs. Okay, up to this, is it clear to you? So next we will move on to the film type IPRT, film. Okay, so first we will discuss the thick film type IPRTs. So thick, what are the features? What are the, attractive features of thick film type IPRTs? More rugged construction, low in cost. If you compare it with the wear type IPRT, okay, so if you compare it, it is relatively at lower cost, okay, compared to the wear type. They are produced by screen printing, okay. Different metals are used. What are the different materials used for making thick film IPRT? So platinum ink is printed on an alumina substrate with a thickness of 5 to 10 micrometer. See, I have basically highlighted this one. Why, I will tell later. And then fired. The finishing process includes trimming to obtain the required resistance, which is coated with a glaze and fired again. Okay, so platinum ink is printed on an aluminium substrate. So first we need an aluminium substrate, then the platinum ink will be printed on that aluminium substrate with a thickness of 5 to 10 micrometer. That's why it is thick, it is called thick film, and then fired. So whenever it will settle down, okay, you have to cut, actually you have to trim, okay, the portion you require for getting the exact resistance, okay. And finally it will be coated with glaze and fired again. Okay, so this is, platinum is the most commonly used for thick film. Nickel chromium alloy is also used to make thick film for special purposes. Now come to the thin film type SPRTs. For thin film, they are more rugged than wear type IPRTs. They are low in cost compared to wear type IPRTs. They are produced by sputtering. So this is the difference. That is screen printing. See this one. This one is thick film is produced by screen printing. Compared to that, it is produced by sputtering. Okay. It is produced by sputtering. So what are the different materials used? Once again,